I'm 4 weeks out, my NPC bikini show downgrading from NPC figure.
I'm getting really tiny, so I want to test my strength to see if I had anything left. Happy to say that I still have some, so this is very exciting for post-competition.
Hi, this is me, Bonnie. In this video, I'm going to give you an update on the last 3 weeks, a throw-up story, my posing, and my wedding, which is going to be less than a week out by the time I post this tomorrow. So, major progress in the last 3 weeks. I started out at 14 weeks out at around 155 pounds at height of 5'6", almost 8 months postpartum. I am now 4 weeks out averaging 135 pounds. So I've lost about 20 pounds, average of about 2 weeks, but of course weight loss is not linear, so it wasn't like every single week was 2 pounds. I am now at only 1400 calories, which is very, very, very low. My last figure show I ended calories at 1600 calories, so I'm definitely hardcore dieting in the traditional bodybuilding sense where you're eating all clean eats. You know, think chicken, brown rice, yams, oatmeal, eggs. I don't even get egg yolks. I've been eating egg whites for the longest time ever. Rice cakes, right? Peanut butter, things like salads, right? Typical dieting food is what I'm on. Been on low calories, low carbs for a very long time already. My cardio is now at 1 hour and 5 minutes, 7 days a week. I'm doing cardio on a machine of my choice, Stairmaster level 10, the entire time. So one big change that contributed to my huge progress in the last week was I've been doing level 9 cardio for the longest time since it was kicking my butt. I was drenched in sweat, but my body got used to it because I was doing every single day and my cardio has been increasing 5 minutes every single week. So I was like, okay, I can't cheat myself. I do need to increase my cardio so that my level of exertion is similar. If I don't finish my cardio, I do have to come back at night and finish it, which really, really, really sucks. At this rate, I might come in on stage at around 130 pounds, which is pretty interesting because in my second figure show, I was 132 pounds at 10% body fat. And then my third figure show is 140 pounds at 10% body fat. So it'll be very interesting to compare because I was coming in at those weights at different stages. So in my second figure show, you know, I was trying to build muscle and trying to maintain the muscle, not lose too much muscle, but lose a lot of fat. And now I'm coming at it from a completely different starting point where I had too much muscle for bikini and I was trying to lose muscle and downsize and lose a lot of fat, which is actually a lot easier to downsize a physique than trying to build muscle at the same time and then, or build muscle and try not to lose that much muscle, etc. So it'll be interesting to see how my body looks. The other thing that I thought was interesting is when I competed last in 2016, yeah, a while ago, I remember bikini competitors coming at like 12, 13% body fat. They didn't need to be as lean or conditioned as figure girls. But now, since the division has evolved and they've become more conditioned and more muscular and not so much like the girls just hop off the cardio machine and go on stage and get made fun of, I do see bikini competitors that are extremely, extremely conditioned, definitely probably 10% body fat on stage. So it is interesting to see how the industry has evolved, and now I am technically a bikini girl based on my body. The goal now is to lose about a pound a week, which is very, very doable. So even though I look okay, definitely ready for the wedding, I'm not stage ready because these bikini girls, they are tiny. I'm feeling like I'm shrinking and I'm becoming skinny, so I can't wait to start lifting again, eating again. But if you look at the bikini front pose, pretty much everyone looks horrendously fat unless they're super, super lean, low body fat. So here in this photo, you can see on the same day I took these, this is my regular front shot photo versus the bikini front shot photo. You can see there's a huge difference here. Now, if I compare myself to the winners at a national show, not regional, but the winner in my height class and the winner in my master's division, you can see that I need to get a lot more tinier. So good thing I made major progress in the last week. Still got ways to go. And on another topic, which I'm gonna save for another video, I could technically go to nationals this year, actually like 1 month later from the June 4th show, and compete in masters. Another story. Here's a little intermission of my Aliana. She has moments where there's just things that make her laugh hysterically, and in this case, it was hiccups. Okay guys, now for my throw up story, which I am now looking back and saying, well, at least I have a story to put in my competition prep diaries. So I just started taking a fat burner that my coach recommended, and I took it with L-carnitine and BCAAs, and I did an hour of fasted cardio on level 10. Afterwards, I was like, I don't know why, but I'm a little nauseous. So I thought, am I low on electrolytes? So I took some electrolytes. And unfortunately, bad timing. This was the day that I had to do my 5 hour trek. Actually, this time it was 5 hours and not 5.5, so that's a little better. 5 hour trek to New Jersey, Patterson, to do in-person posing practice. I have two posing coaches. One is actually Miss Olympia, Angelica Teixeira, which I have to take a selfie with. And then the other one is someone that she had recommended for in-person near the New York City area. As I was going there on the subway and the New Jersey Transit, I was trying to take deep breaths and not throw up. I was like, this is not good. I thought by the time I got on the bus, I should be okay. But this is like an hour ride. I was like running there. I was hot and cold because my body fat's low and I couldn't take off my jacket. I just didn't want to move because I didn't want to throw up. So this entire time, I'm like trying to close my eyes and all this. Long story short, with the bus motion and this being a 1 hour ride, it just couldn't hold it in. And I looked back and there was no bathroom here. I had no bag. And lo and behold, I was that asshole who threw up on the bus. Just all right in front of me. It was really disgusting. And sadly, the guy next to me, he was sleeping the entire time. And then afterwards, I was just like, does anyone have a napkin? And someone gave it to me and nobody told the bus driver. I was kind of sitting in like the middle front area. And when the guy woke up next to me, I was like, I'm sorry, just threw up. You might want to sit over there. And then the sad thing is, then I moved over near the window. I tried to not throw up again the second time. And finally, the stop came, my stop came. And I went to the front and told the driver, I'm sorry, I threw up. And then I left the bus and he's like, oh no, I just didn't feel well. And I literally like leaned against the wall and then I sunk down to the wall, sat on the floor in the sidewalk with my head down, just trying to breathe. And then from the corner of my eye, I see that he let everyone off the bus. But now we're at local stops, thank God. And so everyone had to wait like 7 minutes until they got on the next bus. The driver asked if I needed medical attention. I was like, no. And then I threw up again, a second time, but this time in the streets of ghetto Patterson, New Jersey, in a trash can. I walked 5 minutes to the bodybuilding gym, and there were two judges in the front. I told them this crazy story, and they're like, it happens. You know, it could be that the fat burner was just too strong for you. I'm no longer on that fat burner. It could have been a combination of, you know, adding it with L-carnitine. Also, I was fasted. So I don't know, but I'm definitely not taking anymore. So I've now been recommended a much more milder fat burner. And the thing is, out of all the ingredients that I knew, like there was only two ingredients that I wasn't sure of for the first one, but they're all natural ingredients. So who knows, I guess everybody's bodies react differently. And so unfortunately, I had this 1 hour posing practice, which I was only 5 minutes late for. I'd be damned if all this happened, then I didn't make my posing practice to get more sass. I was still nauseous. And so thank God I had a rice cake with me, and they gave me a Gatorade that I took only a few sips of because it has sugar, right? And then I ended up actually eating everything up that I lost later that night, and I made progress the next day. I felt better. But anyways, it was a really, really horrendous, horrific experience. So that's my throw up story. Very long-winded, I know. But at least I got more sass in my posing with your Conis at Sassy and Classy Posing. And it's been really interesting to have two different posing coaches. That was not my original plan, but very helpful actually to get point of view from obviously Miss Olympia, but also a little stressful because my routine had just kept on changing. Things that I threw in from watching videos, right? Things that I feel like, oh, I feel like I keep on tripping here, or this person thinks I look more sassy this way, or this one flows better. So I'm just glad that I finally have a routine that I'm working on now. 4 weeks out is when I'm getting like a final routine that I'm working on. But very, very excited with my final routine. Posing is the most difficult part of bikini competition, in my opinion. And what's crazy is I think the official time that you're allowed on stage is only 10 seconds at regionals. And there's all this work just to do 10 seconds of presenting, right? I can't imagine how much work is necessary to prepare for posing on the national stage. My wedding is coming up, super excited. It'll be about a week. I'm gonna pick up my dress in 2 days from my aunt. Luckily, she actually worked at a wedding dress factory before. I'm just hoping that my dress is not too big on me since I keep getting smaller and smaller, which I told her, but she can only do so much based on what the design is like. So really excited about that and just everything. The food, I'm excited about the food as well, even though I'm not going crazy and I might have to just taste test my cake, which I've already had. And freeze it. I need to make progress. It's really close. I need to continue to make progress. I'm excited to eat filet mignon, which is not on my eating plan. I have not been able to eat beef since, well, the entire prep, which is crazy because I really miss figure prep dieting for sure. This is our smaller wedding celebration where I get to walk down the aisle because we don't have that in the Chinese culture. So next year later, because of the whole COVID thing, we're gonna have the bigger Chinese banquet celebration, the tea ceremony, the Asian wedding dress, all that, so I'm very excited. And plus I get to eat. If that was happening now, there would definitely be no prep happening. And I already know where we're gonna eat afterwards. Definitely going to Koreatown, craving savory, meaty eats. So like kalbi, spicy pork, all those little mini dishes. Oh my God, I can't wait to eat. That's all I'm thinking about right now. Like food, I had a dream where I was eating at a buffet. And anytime I smell good foods, I'm just like, oh my God, it smells so good. And it really does give me a lot of pleasure and satisfaction. All right, that's it. 4 weeks out. Subscribe, stay tuned, give me a like, leave any comments or questions below, and thanks for watching. Transform, lose fat, lose weight, change your body composition, then check out my special 6-week offer at eatnotdiet.com/peakbody.